make the human body alert and wide awake, you see. And the process is reversed at night. You get many of the enzymes and many of the other chemical compounds that are produced in the human body to let the body relax, you see. And this relaxation is essential for the human existence because many of the living cells die out. Many of the bonds between the nerve cells weaken out. And that's why the very first part of the human body to feel in need for sleeping is the brain. You see? So humans and animals as well need to relax at night to rejuvenate their energy and rejuvenate the cells that they have lost during the day, recorrect any damages that have happened to these cells, especially the nervous system. And of course, the following day, humans and animals can wake up with enough energy to continue life. If I stay awake for 24 hours, one would really lose his brains, you see. And that's why it's a great blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to get that alternation. And at the same time, this alternation reminds us about death and resurrection.
Yes.
And that's why the Quran refers beautifully to the fact that sleeping is equal to death, and waking up from sleep is equal to resurrection. And resurrection has been highly debated by unbelievers and agnostics and people who try to materialize things to the extreme.
So this is a good reason for, and evidence for the non-believers to believe that there is a God who organized.
As I said earlier, you see, there's a great difference with knowledge and guidance. Guidance is a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But knowledge is in filling the books and the encyclopedias and the internet and the like, yes.
Okay, so the alternation is reminding, should be reminding people of the day of resurrection
definitely.
All the time.
And I recall here that a leading professor in the University of London, Professor Arthur Allison. He is the chairman of the engineering, the electrical engineering department at the University of London. And he was fascinated by trying to verify what does the human loses on death. Mm-hmm. And he really exerted lots of energy to try to verify this. And an Egyptian student went to study under him, and he was a bright student. He told them, why do you worry yourself by life and death? I said, what could I do? He said, try to experiment on sleep and awakening, because the Quran equates between sleeping and death and awakening and resurrection from death.
Yes.
And he read for him this verse in Surah Al-Sumar, اللَّهُ يَتَوَفَّى الْأَنفُسَ حِينَ مَوْتِهَا وَالَّتِي لَمْ تَمُتْ فِي مَنَامِهَا فَيُمْسِكُ الَّتِي خَضَ عَلَيْهَا الْمَوْتَى وَأُرْسِلُ الْأُخْرَى إِلَى أَجَلٍ مُسَمَّى. And he said that the Quran clearly equates between sleeping and death and dying and awakening and resurrection from death. So he started to experiment with a case of sleep and awakening, and he found that the human body loses an amount of energy on sleep, and which is almost equal to the amount of energy lost on death. And this verse alone was enough to convince him to accept Islam. And he came to Cairo in 1985, attending a conference on science, Quran and science, and he declared Islam in public, in front of everybody in the conference hall. Yeah.
That's a very important point that we're speaking about today.
Indeed.
Okay, what about the countries who has low number of hours at night and day? Does it affect anything?
Definitely. But by the mercy of Allah, Allah can give them enough immune in their body that can tolerate this.
Yes.
Enough hormones, enough vitamins, enough enzymes, you see, that can tolerate this.
Okay.
But it definitely affects them.
Yes. Okay. So moving to Abdurrahman.
As we see in the verse started by saying that Allah has created earth and sky.
Yes.
And has made darkness and light.
Yes.
Is there a scientific connotation between made and created?
No, I said the beauty in this verse is that he equates night with darkness, and equates the firmament with darkness, and the earth with light. And this is really a very proper correlation. And he said, خلق, creation means starting something out of nothing, you see, without any parallel, without any example before. And وَجَعَلَ الظُّلْمَاتِ وَالنُّورِ, because this is a continuous process. You see, you can make night and day as a continuous process. And that's what he said, Alhamdulillah, الَّذِي خَلَقَ السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَجَعَلَ الظُّلْمَاتِ وَالنُّورِ. And he has made light and darkness and light.
You have attracted my attention to a very important fact. The fact is, from out the outer space, the sun is seen as a spot that emits light. But this light is interpreted in Earth through the atmosphere as this light that illuminates all Earth. This reminded me with the computer. When you have a file, it needs a certain program to read it. So this light is like this file that needs a program to read it. Does this mean that there are other forces in, that are emitted by the sun that can be interpreted or read by a certain factor?
Mechanism, maybe.
And we can use it as a source of energy, like the solar energy.
Yes. But we don't know everything. Mm. So really, we know and we do not know. So we know very little of what's there. And yet, some people try to appear as if they know everything. But really, the more you know, the less you feel you know.
The alternation of day and night, would we find other stars other than Earth having the same alternation?
Definitely. The system is one.
Okay.
When scientists went to the moon had day and night.
Yes.
And the Earth worked like a moon for the moon. Mm-hmm. You see, the moon for them became like an Earth.
At the time, at a certain angle, at a certain place, they see Earth as the moon.
Because you see, one of the living testimonies for the oneness of the Creator is the unity of creation. You see, we have norms, we have universal laws that runs everywhere.
Yes. Professor, I'd like to end this by a very important point that you've mentioned. It's about the alternation of day and night and having the Creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, reminding people with this every day alternation that there will be a day of resurrection for everyone. And people should be really reminded with this fact that will help them maybe on the religious side be prepared for such a day.
Definitely. You see, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is quoted to have said, وَاللَّهِ لَتَمُوتُنَّ كَمَا تَنَمُونَ وَلَتُبَعْثُنَّ كَمَا تَسْتَيْقِظُونَ. In the name of Allah, you will die in exactly the same way you go to sleep. And you will be resurrected in exactly the same way you wake up from sleep. You see, so really, the alternation of day and night, the alternation of sleeping and awakening, would remember everybody for the moment of death and the moment of resurrection.
Okay, Professor Zaghloul Naggar, we thank you very much. It was a pleasure having you here at the TV. Okay, my dear guest, Abdurrahman, and sorry, I forget your name, Zabihullah, which is a very special name. Yes, exactly, cannot be forgotten.
Cannot be forgotten.
Exactly, one of a kind. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you.
Okay. And with this, we come to the end of this edition of Quran and Science. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bum 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 bum.